they're shouting the winners' names aloud.
'Cause it's the greatest game in town,
and it's the craziest fun around.
It's a knockout,
that's the name.
It's a knockout,
that's the game.
It's a knockout,
that's the name of the game.
The last heated round two of It's a Knockout. Let's hear it for this evening's themes. With a great chance of making our Rich City Finals, the team led by Bruce Laverton, they'll go hell for leather to achieve as many points as possible wearing the red strip for St George, New South Wales. Also looking to a semi-final berth is the team under the leadership of Peter Bolton. A repeat of their form in the earlier heats will see them safely home in the blue colours for Melbourne City, Victoria. Yet another contender for a shot at next week's $10,000 first prize is the team led by Jock Howard. Consistency has got them this far and could well carry them right through in the yellow for Northern Park, Queensland. Every competition has its battlers, and the team from the Festival State led by Ian Robertson has struggled to find form all season. To their credit, they're still fighting on in the green for Woodville, South Australia. To fill in the details of the teams, the players and the games, your hosts, Billy J. Smith and Fiona McDonald.
Hey, what a little beauty. Oh. I love it.
All set for our big race a little bit later on, which we'll be telling you about in the show. G'day.
Oh, beauty, how are you? You make a good racing car driver, Billy, but I suppose we should have had helmets on, shouldn't we, really?
I was just a little bit worried about the front there.
Oh.
Might have taken off on it.
We won't go into technical details.
All right, folks, nice to have you along once again. This is the last heat in round number two. We've got three possible semi-finalists on the show tonight, which is beaut, and it should be a pretty close tussle all the way.
It certainly should. They're very competitive. And with reason, there's $11,000 on offer next week, as well as the chance to get into our grand final going into this final heat. The points table sees Manly lead the New South Wales section with 33 points. St George on 29 need 5 points this evening to tip Manly out.
Alrighty, there's a close go in the Victorian section as well, where Eltham lead, having finished with 61 points, Melbourne City on 59, and this heat to play. They only want 3 points for victory.
Mount Gravatt lead the Queensland division, finishing on 49 points, and that leaves Norman Park on 42, needing 8 points to top their division.
And Stirling have the South Australian section all sewn up on 60 points. Woodville play this evening, and it'd be nice to see this battling team pick up some consolation prize money. Our referee tonight remembered for his great performance in the Network 10 mini-series, Return to Eden. Here with Lions ladies, Liz and Lana, a fine actor, Warren Blondell. How are you, Warren?
How are you, Billy?
Hi, Warren.
It's a lovely day.
It is good, and you've got some teams that will be really going flat out tonight because they are looking for a place in the semis.
I bet they are.
So you'll have to keep a close eye on them.
Yeah, very close eye.
You're pretty fit anyway, aren't you? You go running on the beach and stuff?
Every day.
Oh, you'll be fine, no problem.
I should be competing. What are you talking about?
What are you talking about? Running? Why don't you run off? Oh, get across and get ready for our very first game tonight.
Did you see the speedy movie? Yeah. Four pedigreed pooches battle it out for points in our first game, Canine Crossing. They go through all sorts of obstacles just to deliver a bone and a ball to their kennel maids.
The girls act as callers at the end when the dogs can't see where they're going. All four teams line up together, and to get them off and running, here's Warren Blondell.
These dogs are looking very mean and hungry. I better let them start.
All right, the red dog up there is Ray Bentley. Underneath there, his helpers will be Megan Law and Joanne McCormick.
Robert for the blue team, it's Michael Norton. He's a phys ed teacher. Wow, he's leaping through really well. His helpers, Pai Barbaras and Sue Nagel.
For Norman Park, Jock Out is in there doing the job, and Joe Crozier and Nikki Rich are helping out.
And finally, for the green team, it's Fido down there. Doug Stewart, he's a finance officer who does a bit of aerobics. His helpers are Kerry Hurley and Robin Pleggett.
The Victorian dog coming through, that's Snoopy. He's taken the lead at this stage.
Yeah, Michael Snoopy Norton doing very well. Throwing that bone.
There's his bone straight over the top. Now he tries to get through that maze of ropes. Queensland and New South Wales in second spot at the moment.
And poor old Woodville taking up the tail.
Coming down now over the slippery section where Snoopy's trying to pick up his bone.
It's very, very precarious on this bit. Can he make it? It looks like he will.
Another tube to go, and then he gets the beach ball in his mouth.
He's got to get that bone through the hoop, and then he's got to put himself through.
So here's Victoria. Not much between it for second spot at the moment. They're all there.
No, Pluto and Rover just about to go through. Look, Snoopy doing well here.
Snoopy picking up his bone. Now he's got his beach ball, and away he goes. He's running down to the line. He's going pretty well at the moment, is Snoopy.
Yeah, there he is.
There Let's wait for our second spot now. It's a battle between Queensland and New South Wales at the moment. Queensland coming through just ahead of New South Wales. He's going, getting by. Oh, he's going to the wrong one.
Oh,
and the red one's fallen under everything. Right, I warned you had plenty of action there, didn't you?
Yes, mate. Yellow second, blue first.
All right, yes, that's it. Victoria getting a good start here. Let's see what they think about it.
Well, it's a little bit hot inside that dog.
Oh, it's very hot. I tell you what, I know how those big beer-drinking men feel now.
I guess that's why you probably ran like mad.
I was just trying to get the sound as fast as I could.
Which was the hardest part of the course for you?
Well, I think still getting this gut through the hoops is the hardest part. I'm not so used to that.
Okay, good calling there too.
Oh, thank you.
Congratulations, Blue. Good start.
All right, good start.
Right, points coming out of that one. Queensland will pick up two for their second spot. And, of course, Victoria, our winning team, will get four. Teams of monks have a hard journey ahead. In fact, it's a marathon for all of them. Marathon Monks is game number two and comes up on the other side of the break.
It's a knockout, that's the name of the game.
Well, it's a nice start for Victoria.
Yeah, good to see them moving through to the semi.
Yeah, they've done it there. Righto, let's get ready for Marathon Monks. And in heat number one, it's New South Wales up against Victoria. Here's Fiona now with the team from St George.
Well, Bruce Laverton, you're captain for this heat. And Ray Bentley, you've moved up from the reserve to replace Alan Andrews, captain who was out last week with injury. What happened?
When he was jumping down from the ladder event, he twisted his ankle pretty badly. So he's taken to hospital, but he's all right now.
Well, he's over there cheering everybody on. What's his advice been to you to try and win this one?
Just try hard.
Okay, well, that's a good one. You've got a good support group over there. Do you think you can do it?
We'll try hard for him.
All right, off you go. Good luck.
Okay.
We're over here with Melbourne City, Peter and Mike. Well, the good news is you're into the semi-finals.
Hey, that's fantastic, isn't it? Looks like we can keep the momentum up now.
Yeah, well, you might as well go. Even though you made the semis, you might as well go for that $1,000 here tonight.
Hey, why not?
Okay, all the best.
Thank you.
All right, Melbourne City on their way for heat number one.
And teamwork is essential here in this game as pairs of monks carry their little dinghies over an obstacle course into the water, and they have to try and pick up a jug of wine and some bread and bring it back first.
All righty, yes, they're going to be back there sitting at that table with their paddles too, I might add. We might get ready for heat number one, and Warren, you can start them moving.
Don't forget the paddles.
Men of the cloth, are you ready?
So for the red team, it's Bruce Laverton. He's a police officer, and his partner, Ray Bentley, who's also a police officer.
Over there in the blue for Melbourne City, Michael Norton and also Peter Bolton. Now, they both do triathlons, so they'll be fit enough to give this one a bit of a shake from here.
Yeah, they've already proved that they're pretty fit. Michael Norton winning the first event in that dog suit, which is no mean feat. Oh, dropped a paddle. That's lost a bit of time for them.
Well, they've had to pick them up before they could go over that seesaw.
Gee, this is what we mean by teamwork. These guys working really well together here for Blue.
Over the second seesaw, up the stairs and into the pool to start paddling their way downstream.
Meanwhile, a bit of fumbling back down here for the red team, having a few problems getting over those obstacles.
So the Blues doing it quite nicely. They've got to go around the outside of that pontoon to pick up their bread and wine. As you can see, they're starting to get their course plotted out now. They'll take it from there.
Okay, New South Wales getting into the water a little bit late, but they're on their way too.
So Victoria arriving. They have the bread. There goes the wine. And all they have to do is paddle back and make sure they get to that table first.
Oh, gee, the red's putting in a big effort here, but I don't know that it's going to help them. But, gee, the Blues seem to be getting off course a lot here.
Yeah, the reds have paddled up furiously up there at this stage, and they're going to get their bread and wine now. But Victoria have a bit of a break on them at this stage.
Gee, look at those reds desperately trying to catch up, but I think Blues have done it.
Down to the edge. Now they'll bail out and head up to that table now.
Got the wine, got the bread, and it's an easy victory for Victoria.
All righty, they're coming up there, about to do it all right, and down they go. All right, Warren, you might confirm that one for us, thank you.
Very easy victory to Victoria.
Okay, they make their way through to the final. Here's our second heat, and Fiona catches up with Norman Park.
Jock Howard and Marshall Butterworth, well, you guys need 8 points to get through to the semi tonight. How tough do you think it's going to be against this field?
It's going to be extremely tough because they're good teams. They're good teams.
They certainly are. Now, this seems to me to be a weird event to choose a joker in. Why here?
Well, we're pretty sort of devout people in our own way, and we figure that we'll get some divine intervention.
Oh, okay, you might need it. All right, go for it.
Thank you.
Getting across over here with Doug and Ian right now. Well, things haven't gone exactly well for the Woodville team.
No, not well at all. We can only get better from here, though.
Is this going to be the breakthrough night tonight?
Hopefully.
I hope it is for you, too. How do you think you'll handle this one?
We'll give it a good go. Yeah, we think we could win this one.
All right, I hope you do.
Thank you.
Oh, no, there's South Australia on their way right now.
Okay, Queensland using a joker against South Australia. Let's see who's getting going to get through to the final, Warren?
Have you said your prayers, fellas? We'll see who's are answered then, won't we?
All right, Queensland using the joker, remember, with Jock Howard in action and also Marshall Butterworth.
And the Woodville team, who are on the bottom of the pile but desperately trying to win tonight, that's Doug Stewart. He runs marathons, and Ian Robertson, his partner, who's a technical officer.
The yellow team from Queensland got a bit of a lead at the moment. They're heading up over the seesaw. Now the hump and then another seesaw before they make their way to the water.
Yeah, these boys seem to have figured it out pretty well. They're just strolling, Billy. They're not even running.
Yeah, they're not going flat out at the moment, taking their time as they get up there.
Oh dear, all sorts of problems down here, losing paddles and having difficulties for the South Australians.
So Queensland are into the water. They'll start their paddle up there now to get the wine and the bread.
And they're coordinating really well, this Queensland team. Where are the South Australians going? Oh my goodness.
I think they're lost over there these days, going round in circles.
I don't think they know where they're going. So they've left it right open for the Queenslanders. They've grabbed their wine.
And they now have the bread on board also. So they're starting their paddle back now.
So South Australia, I don't know where they're going.
They're all going round in circles at the moment.
South Australians have made it difficult for the Queenslanders who are trying to turn around.
What have they done up there? I think they've lost the paddle. That's their problem.
Oh my goodness, come on, quick.
So they've got it now and they can start their paddle home.
Gee, this has made it made the race a bit more even, hasn't it? Because as they come up to the pontoon, there are the South Australians grabbing their wine and bread.
Now the battle on the way home. Queensland paddling a little bit stronger than South Australia at the moment.
This is going to be tight. The Queenslanders need this. They've got their joker going.
So now they're getting up to the end.
It's going to be close.
Out they go now. They've got the break on them at this stage.
Don't lose that bread. Here comes South Australia.
Coming up to the... I don't think they know where they are, these boys. At the moment. They're a bit there. Wow, it took long enough to get there, but they finally made it. Let's get it with Warren. Thank you.
A truly inspired performance by Queensland. Number one.
All righty, they make their way through to the final
now. All right, well, they've won it once, but can they do it against those terrific Victorians? Let's see how they go.
All right, Warren, you can start them going.
This is a final, fellas, so no monkeying around, OK?
Right, I'll tell you firstly about the team coming through in the blue from Victoria. We have Michael Norton and Peter Bolden there.
And for the yellow team, going for their joker, it's Jock Howard and Marshall Butterworth.
Now let's have a look at them. Queensland caught up a little bit in the net there. Victoria not going through too quickly either. Jock Howard's fallen over there for the Queensland team. He's lost his paddle. Now they come back.
Oh dear, I think the Blues are going to do them here.
Going along quite nicely. Queensland have got their joker in action on this event. Blues going up to the water now. Queensland about to make their way there too.
Ooh, these funny little rafts want to go everywhere but straight ahead.
Away they go. Let's see what happens in the water now.
Okay, so Queensland catching up a little bit, but Blues rounding the pontoon and grabbing their wine and bread.
They've got it. On board, lost the bread. They've got to scoop it up and they're still having trouble getting their bread. Now they've got it.
Okay, so both teams coming round and there's Queensland with their bread. Gee, this is going to be a good race.
Now we start the paddle back now, but Victoria got a bit of a start on the Queensland team who are a bit off course. Now they straighten up.
Yeah,
Victoria down to the end. Jumping out.
Wait a minute, they've lost their bread.
They've lost their bread, they lost the wine, which has rolled right down the hill.
Gee, this is Queensland.
Now they're coming back to the table. Okay, Warren, what have we got here?
Well, a bit of a tussle, but Victoria got in.
All right, the Blues have made it there. Let's see what they think about it. Fiona catches up with them over there.
Boy, talk about a fumble finger.
That's his Aussie rules school. Seeing how far he could kick the thing.
How did you feel when you saw that jug rolling down the steps?
I didn't know what to do. I didn't know to rub it or what, because we're getting a journey.
Well, it looks like luck's with you tonight, guys, because you've won again.
Excellent. Let's keep that going. Let's go, Blue.
Points coming on the board. Queensland using their joker. They get 4, and we also see Victoria getting 4 points out of that event too. We'll see both rocking and rolling. The next event is the guys pilot giant hoops along the course. The name of the game is Rolling Hoops, and we'll bring it to you in just a moment.
It's a knockout. That's the name of the game.
Well, only two teams bothering to do any scoring at the moment.
Oh, don't give up on the other ones. The red team has still got a chance there.
The red and the green have still got to get some points on the board. We'll see what they can do it in this event.
Yeah, it's Blue who are going for it again in this event. They've got their joker riding on this one and they have to get inside egg-shaped hoops and try and make them roll down the course, busting balloons as they go.
And they do a couple of laps of that and it's pretty torrid going. So we might start them on their way right now. Here's one.
Okay, Billy, I'll get these rockers rolling.
You do yourself, Warren, and I'll tell the folks about the teams. Over there on the red for St George, we have Bruce Laverton, who plays a bit of golf and squash, and also Ray Bentley, who's into indoor cricket.
For Melbourne City, the guys who've got their joker on this, Michael Norton, who's a phys ed teacher, and Peter Bolton, who's a businessman.
Queensland team going along pretty well at the moment. They're leading at this stage and just busting another balloon. We have Jock Howard in there and also Marshall Butterworth.
Yeah, the Queensland team, they need two more points to get through to the semi tonight.
And the way they're going, there are a big chance of doing that in this event.
Oh dear, the blue team having all sorts of problems. They might have to get out and re-straighten their hoop, I think.
So the Queensland team scooting away from the others at the moment.
Wow, they're doing a brilliant job there. So it's Green who are coming into the second spot here.
Yeah, right, just ahead of New South Wales and Victoria. They're back at the tail and they're the team using their joker. Queensland have just burst their final balloon. They get up to the end of that, they start off and they're on their way back now.
Looking for a couple of points here and it looks like they might just get them too.
On their way down now for lap number two.
So blue team are still coming last here. They've at least got to get second spot.
South Australia and New South Wales are battling it out for the second spot at the moment.
Both teams have no points on the board at the moment, so it'd be nice. Oh, South Australia have to roll back on that balloon. They missed it.
There's Queensland doing a good job of it at the moment. They're still the only team who are on their way back on lap number two.
Gee, they've really got this one figured out, haven't they?
South Australia, meantime, have had trouble. They've gone around the side of their balloon, so they've got to go back and straighten up and try and do it.
So it's Queensland heading for the finishing line.
Yes, here they go, coming along very firmly now. That'll be enough to get them into the semi-final for them.
Gee, not far now. Millie over, there they go. One more turn and they'll have done
it. One more to go. For it, Queensland well and truly streeting them in this one. Waiting for second spot to be worked out now.
Gee, they're close.
Can Victoria come through? They're the joker team in this event.
Victoria gaining a couple of rolls on the other teams here, but they stop.
Just failing to get over that one. Straightening up now as they go. South Australia going to be all course, they're going to have to straighten up.
They're over the line, they'll have to stop.
Well over the line, here's Victoria coming through. Can they take second spot? Here they go, they've got a roll going at the moment.
Yeah, they've got it going.
And there they are. Righto.
What a great race. Blue second, Queensland first.
All righty, Queensland, well and truly winners there. Let's get across with them now.
Well, you guys absolutely flew and you were hopeless in rehearsal. How did you manage it?
Pure luck.
Was it?
We fell in the right places at the right time.
There must be a bit of a knack to making those things move. What is it?
March my fall over a hell of a lot.
Oh, okay, you've mastered the art of falling over. Well done. Hey, I think you're through to the semi.
Ah, far out. Yeah, I forgot about that.
Good on you.
Oh, good. Thanks very much.
Well, plenty of excitement over there. Let's have a look at the points. Victoria using their joker, so they get four out of that one. And Queensland being the winners also get four. There's aerial action to follow on event four as players leap in the air to play spring ball. Join us and the teams right after this break. It's a Well, they're at the halfway mark and still it's a two-team affair.
A lot of excitement for Queensland.
Victoria just hanging on to that lead at the moment. All right, our next game is one called Spring Ball in the first heat. We have Victoria up against Queensland. And here's Fiona talking with Pi Barbaras now from Victoria.
Pi, I know that you're quite good buddies with the Queenslanders, but do you think you can beat them in this?
Well, we've got a few basketballers up there, so hopefully we'll be right.
How's your catching, though?
I wish I'd taken lacrosse lessons.
Okay, well, you can't afford to lose any more games from now on.
No, that's right.
All right. Into your little boat and off
you
go. Good luck.
Over here with Joe Crozier now from the Norman Park team. Well, everyone's happy you've made the semis.
Yeah, it's wonderful. Very happy.
They really good. What did you do to the boys in that one? They really went right off.
I really don't know.
What about this one? How's your catching?
Well, I've been practicing with the fishing net, so it should be okay.
All righty. Well, all the best.
Thank you, Julie.
Okay, there's Queensland on their way for heat number one.
And we've set them a real task in this one. The team members have to jump from a diving board, throw a ball through a suspended hoop, and then their teammate has to try and catch it.
Have to see how many they can get in our time limit of 1.5 minutes. So we might start off with heat number one.
Okay, fellas, good shooting.
Okay, from Melbourne City, it's Pi Barbaras doing the catching. Michael Norton, Sue Nagel, Peter Bolton, Jane Donges, and Simon Rudy will be doing the throwing.
And they're on to a flying start here, two in the rack already. There's number three coming in now, the Queensland team. Jo Crozier, who we met a short time ago, she is the catcher. And up there doing the work from the top of the galleon, we have Marshall Butterworth, Nikki Rich, Jock Howard, Roz Austin and Mel Wilkinson.
Both these two teams doing pretty well, but both of them need to because, Oh, did you see it? It almost went in by itself.
There were some amazing belly flops coming up on this one too.
Yeah, both these teams are very close on the board, so no more jokers left to use. They have to win.
Right, let's have a look at it now. There's Victoria, just had a little bit ahead at the moment.
Delayed jump there from Victoria, and there's a ball for Queensland.
Yeah, that's three on the wall for them now.
Oh dear.
There's number four for them.
A miss there for Victoria. I think that just about levels the teams up now. Oh no, a miss there.
Yeah, but Queensland got one in, so that's enough to take them to the lead.
Okay, can this one...
Yes! Oh, good work, Victoria.
A catch! So they're tying now.
Coming along and with just on 15 seconds remaining.
There's another one for Victoria and for Queensland. Gee, it's close.
Neck and neck they go. This could be the decider coming up. Can he get it? Yes, they can.
I don't think they're going to have enough time to do any more.
Well, there's another one for the yellow team. And there goes our time. Time is up. Righto, Warren, have you got a total there for us?
Victoria with six, but Queensland going to the final with eight.
All right, good work there by the Norman Park team. We're ready for heat number two, and let's get a crossover here with New South Wales.
Well, Megan, it's been a pretty tough night tonight as far as competition goes.
Yeah, it has, but we always do our best towards the end of the show.
So. Okay, well, you've only got three games left, and you've got to get 5 points, I think, to get through to the semi. Is that right?
That's right, yeah.
Okay, can you make four of those points in this one?
Well, we're going to try.
How good you're catching?
Pretty good.
Can you thrash this screen person?
Well, yep, I think so.
Okay, good luck.
Right, Kerry Hurley over here. What's happening with this green team? The green machine's not revving up.
I know. We had a lot of luck in our last show, but this one, it was just... Oh.
Well, maybe the luck will come this time around.
Hopefully.
All right, I'll let you get over there and get ready to do a bit of catching for us.
Oh, come on, good cheering for these guys. They both need points. All right, green against red.
Thanks, Warren, you can start them going.
Thank you, Billy. Okay, boys.
Right, let's have a look at the teams coming up now. Firstly, in the red for New South Wales, Megan Lawrence, the catcher. That's Bruce Laverton you saw just go through, and also Joey McCormick just hitting the water. Ray Bentley, Julie Nicholson and Damien Corbett follow on from there.
Ooh, over there for the green team, Kerry Hurley. She's caught a couple of balls now. That's good work. And now throwing them to her are the team members, Doug Stewart, Robin Cleggett, Ian Robertson, Dawn Christopher and Grant Wiles.
There's some amazing belly flops coming up at this one too. Ooh, I can tell you. Just missing out there in New South Wales.
And a very funny belly flop there for South Australia.
Okay, it's New South Wales getting to the front now. Three in there for them.
Yeah, just a little bit ahead. Oh, there's another one that puts them even further ahead. No good for South Australia, that one. So it's... I thought it might have been another ball for both of them, but both balls missed there.
All right, at this stage, there are 30 seconds remaining in the game. Woo! And yes,
a close one there. I thought she was going to lose it.
Picked up over there by Kerry.
So, New South Wales still ahead at this stage. And that was a big hit, wasn't it?
Very strong one.
Oh, a bit of mid-air flying there.
There's our time limit up, and we might get across to Warren so he can sort them out for us.
South Australia 3, New South Wales into the final with 6.
All right, good work from them. They'll be up against the team from Queensland.
All right, let's see who's going to get the big points up on the board. Here's Warren to start them.
Okay, boys, good luck.
So here we go now. I'll tell you about New South Wales first up. Megan Law, the catcher again. Bruce Laverton just gone through. Joanne McCormick, Ray Bentley, Julie Nicholson and Damien Corbett.
And for the other team, it's Jo Crozier doing the catching for Queensland. Her team, Marshall Butterworth, Nikki Rich, Jock Howard, Roz Austin and Mel Wilkinson.
There are some spectacular dives going up here. Another one in for the yellow team.
Red not having much luck at this one.
Whoop, got one in there though.
There we go. Maybe they've come... The tides have turned for them.
Whoa, got another one.
I love it when they fall.
Yes, that's levelled it up for them.
Wow.
A little bit short there.
Queensland's doing well.
And another.
Gee, they've really figured this one out.
30 seconds to go now.
Whoa, good catch in for Megan for New South Wales. Queensland yelling.
Oh, and another one there for New South Wales.
Joe Crozier yelling out for her teammates.
All trying desperately to get some essential ones here at the moment. Straight over the heads they go.
Julie Nicholson throwing that ball for New South Wales. Oh, they missed.
No one for Queensland.
Queensland caught it. Bit hard to see who's going to win this one.
All right, there's our time limit. Oh, this is going to be close. Warren, have you got a winner there for us?
New South Wales 6, Queensland 8.
Oh, so the yellow team have got it. That's good for them. Let's go poolside with Fiona.
Okay, what a team.
Yay.
That's not an easy game to play either, is it?
It's all timing.
Did you actually get one of your balls into the net?
I don't think.
Yes.
And congratulations, Joe. Great catching.
Thank you very much.
All right, more points on the board for you guys.
All right, let's have a look at them. Firstly, we'll put up 2 for New South Wales. That's their first points of the night. Good work for them. And Queensland getting 4, and that'll take them to the lead. A different kind of Grand Prix sees a race against the clock in which the drivers carry a precious cargo of eggs. It may turn out to be a mad scramble. Join us for it in just a moment. Well, let's have a look up there, and what do we see? A pretty tight battle going on at the moment between the two teams that have been there all night.
Yeah, we're going to have to get a bit of a move on for the green team, though.
Yeah, well, New South Wales have broken their ducks, and they need a couple more to make the semis too, so
yeah,
they'll be going
they
flat out from here.
They need 5. Okay, well, maybe they can pick up a few in Grand Prix. In this one, the drivers have to pick their speed very carefully, because when they drive over their course, their teammates have eggs balanced on their heads.
They have to get round to the quickest possible time, and of course, if they lose an egg, a couple of seconds gets added onto their time.
Makes
and if they arrive with no eggs at all, we don't even count them.
Oh, dear.
So let's start off. Here's Victoria lining up for heat number one.
Here's Victoria with heat one.
Right, and let's have a look now for Victoria. Peter Bolton going over there to jump in and start up from there.
His team members are Michael Norton, Sue Nagel and Kai Barbaros.
So let's have a look now. He's moving around pretty swiftly and all eggs are intact at the moment.
Oh, speed bump coming up.
Oh, safely through that one. Now, here's a bit of a test.
Now, he had a bit of
trouble. Oh, they went off wholesale there.
He did have trouble on Knockout Hill last time.
Oh, another one gone.
Dear. Oh. All we need is one egg for a time, though, and they are setting quite a pace at the moment, which is good.
Yes, Peter's moving them along quite quickly here.
So still 4 eggs, I think, on the front. Oh, it might only be 3, I'm not sure. But anyway, there they go, up to that final part of the course.
Down to the line, and there they go. Right, we might work it out over there with Warren.
Right, Billy, we've got 3, 7, 8, that's 16, that makes 64.
Okay, that's not a bad way to start, is it?
Not too bad. Okay, South Australia, next up for Grand Prix, and they're using their joker.
Is this going to be the chance for the green team? We will find out. Let's get going. Thanks, Warren.
This is South Australia playing their joker in heat 2.
Let's see how they go. The man running across here to take control is Ian Robertson.
And a 5-second run. Here's our team members, Doug Stewart, Robin Cleggett and Kerry Hurley.
I think the best part of this is the concentration on the faces.
Oh, it looks absolutely agonising.
Oh, there's a couple gone.
Okay, plant that foot and over Knockout Hill.
Another one gone.
And we still have a few eggs on board there.
Yeah, they're doing all right. Oh, there's another one just slipped off.
So taking it carefully around that tight corner.
Into the one on Ben now.
Into the what Ben?
The bottom Ben now.
Oh, the bottom Ben.
Coming back.
There we go, through the
pretty nicely. Looks pretty good for them.
Sure does. So we just have to count up those eggs. They're over.
Okay, we might get down and check out with Warren what sort of a time we've got.
Right, we've got 9 eggs broken at 2 seconds each. That's 18, plus the score makes 66.
So not quite quick enough for them.
No, oh well, not to worry. Let's see how the New South Wales team go. They're next up.
All right, Warren, you can start them moving now.
New South Wales, good luck in heat 3.
The New South Wales driver is Bruce Laverton. He's on his way. He's a policeman. He won't speed.
No, well, he'd have a good driving sort of ability, though.
Well, and let's have a look.
His team members, fellow policemen Ray Bentley, Giant McCormick and Megan Law.
And down they go, still totally intact at the moment.
Oh, the back passengers clenching their teeth as they go over there.
They're okay, they haven't lost any as yet.
And over.
Oh, they have now.
Gee, look at Bruce. Isn't he intent on driving here? He's really serious about this.
Around that turn.
Here he goes through the archway. Oh, we're losing eggs everywhere. Oh, we lost the whole hat. Oh, we forgot to duck. Oh, dear.
Okay, let's check it out. What have you got, Warren?
Well, we've lost 8 eggs. 2 seconds each is 16, which equals 105.
Whoa! Close, very close.
Just
1 second.
Just in the middle there.
Yeah, okay, one more team left to go through it, the Queenslanders.
So, Warren, you can start them going now.
Okay, Queenslanders, this is the final heat.
So Jock Howard is away and he'll jump behind the wheel and start Queensland on their way.
And the team for the yellows, Marshall Butterworth, Nicky Rich and Joe Crozier.
Right, let's have a look now how they go. The time to beat here, by the way, is 1 minute and 4 seconds. Stands to the credit of Victoria, they were our first team to go round. But the rest just very, very close near them.
Jock taking it very carefully. I don't know that he's going to beat that first time. Oh, he threw a few eggs.
Now he's failed to negotiate the corner there.
Oh, wow, what is going on?
Trouble in the camp here.
Okay, we are having a bit of a time. I wonder where Jock got his license. So over he goes. Yeah, I hope he doesn't fall off the hill.
Jock, we do have to finish tonight.
So around the corner he goes. He's doing well on the egg score, but as far as time on the board, it's coming up to a minute. There he goes, round that corner.
Down there. And around.
And it seems to be taking forever, this drive.
Down to the line. And there he goes. All right, the time's not too flash. Let's check it out and see what it exactly is. Thanks, Warren.
Okay, we've got 2, 4, that's 8. Plus 111 is 119.
Wow, that's just a little bit too long. It means our winning score is 1 minute and 4 seconds to Victoria. And here's Fiona down there catching up with them now.
Hey, Peter! Peter, great drive!
Oh, it was an excellent drive, wasn't it?
Oh, please, no egg jokes. That was wonderful, though. You were 2 points behind Norman Park, but now things are looking much better.
They are looking a little better. We've got to continue the next game.
Do you think you can win the night now?
Oh, it's going to be a tough effort. The next event's very hard, but I hope so.
All right, well, if your fans are cheering for you, give yourselves a cheer.
Okay, let's go.
Coming out of the event, we'll put up 2 points there for New South Wales and we'll put up 4 for Victoria. There's plenty of heaving and lifting going on at the last event as the teams endeavour to load the loft. Vital points can be gained in this final game right after this break. About a good game with our final event for tonight.
Yeah, and 3 teams doing very well up there.
Well, let's have a look at that board before we go into our final event tonight. We have South Australia, no points on the board, but maybe this last event could be the one. 4 up there for New South Wales. We have Queensland on 14, and we have Victoria, our leading team at the moment, on 16 points. Final event coming up is Load the Loft. Let's get across now as Fiona catches up with New South Wales.
Well, Bruce, it has been a bit of a slow night for New South Wales, hasn't it?
Definitely, very slow tonight.
But is 4 points enough to take you through to the semi-final?
Yes, so we've achieved what we set out to do, and that's points to qualify.
Congratulations. That's great. Now, look, there'd be very few people who'd be brave enough to put a joker on the next event. Why have you chosen it?
Oh, it's our specialist event. We think we're going to have a big win here.
So we've got a few muscles here?
Yes, we've been weightlifting and all sorts of things.
All right, we'll go for it. Good luck.
Thanks, Luke.
Thanks. Okay, we're across with Victoria, our leading team at the moment, but Queensland right behind you.
They're hot on our tails, aren't they?
Yeah, it's been a bit... Well, they've been around. You've been round together just about all night, haven't you?
That's true. That's true.
Can you knock them out of business this time?
I certainly hope so.
All right, well, once you get into it. Let's get across over there with those Queenslanders now.
Jock, it's about your driving.
I'm sorry, I had a few.
You got it in a cereal packet, right?
That's right.
Okay, well, you didn't do so well at that last event, but how about this one coming up now? You've got to get points to beat these Victorians.
That's right. Well, we were pretty aggressive in the egg one. We're going to be even more aggressive in this one.
How did you go in practice?
Well, it's pretty hard practicing for this one, mate, because ladders and lofts and all that are pretty hard to come by around our way.
All right. Do you think you can thrash them, though?
Oh, definitely, yep.
Okay, confidence.
All righty, we're over here with South Australia. What is happening here?
I don't know. Very fun.
Well, that's right. All righty, well, let's see if we can go out with a bang in your last game of the Tanaka.
Thanks, Billy.
Okay. Here's Fiona across over there with Warren now.
Well, Warren, it's been really tough competition tonight.
Oh, absolutely.
Everyone taking it seriously. Who do you think's going to win?
Well, I hope Victoria's going to win because they're the winning team so
Maya,
far.
Who do you think's going to win, girls?
I knew they'd say that.
All right, will we get these guys started on the last event?
Why not?
Okay.
Okay, convicts, get ready to grab your bags and tug those ropes.
All right, well, firstly, New South Wales, the team is St George, and they are using their joker in this final event tonight. And that's Ray Bentley going up there to get bag number one and helping down the bottom are Bruce Laverton and Megan Law.
And for Melbourne City, it's Peter Bolton who's doing the climbing up there, Michael Norton and Sue Nagel doing the hard work down the bottom.
Jock Howard is in action over there for Norman Park. He's just put up bag number one and he's on his way down now. Marshall Butterworth and Nikki Richard down the bottom there.
And for Woodville, it's Ian Robertson who's doing the climbing and Doug Stewart and Robin Claggett who are pulling him up there, hauling those bags.
Let's have a look at it now. Victoria just ahead of South Australia, Queensland and New South Wales. Very little between them on bag number two.
So the big competition now for the money for the night. They've all made it through to the, well, three of them have made it through to the semis. New South Wales are using their joker, but I don't know, Billy, do you think they can do it?
Well, they're hard up against it at the moment. This Victorian team are pretty hot. They're leading at the moment and they want to stay that way. They've got their eye on $1,000 at the moment.
Well, this is surprising because the Victorians said they didn't think they could do it to me earlier.
They're starting a little bit slower on it now, but we'll see what happens. They've got a good lead, although there's South Australia coming through.
Yep.
Queensland back in third, and also coming through there is New South Wales.
So there's three up there for Victoria, and coming back down for bag number four.
Yeah, Peter Bolton down for his last one now.
New South Wales unhooking their bag, putting their number up, and so of South Australia.
Yeah, they're down. Queensland having trouble on clipping the bag up there at the moment. But there's Victoria going through.
There's their fourth bag.
He's about to unhook bag number four, the final one now.
There's that number going up and...
They'll all have to gather on the pontoon down the bottom and away he goes. And there they are. Good work. They've done it, Victoria. Battle for second spot coming up now. New South Wales on the way down. Whoa, there they go. Coming in with their joker too, which is good news for them. And there they are. Right.
Well, it looks like blue came in first and red second.
Alrighty, let's have a look at that point score. Firstly, we'll put up for New South Wales 4 points. They use their joker. We'll give Victoria four. There are our outright winners for tonight. Victoria, here are the blue team now.
Well, that was fantastic. And you guys told me you couldn't do it.
Well, we shocked ourselves. Wow, what a load.
Why spoil a perfect record? That means you've won every night that you've competed. Congratulations.
Right. Thank you. Fantastic.
We give away our last $1,500 before moving on to the big money next week. Be with us shortly as we announce the teams who will fight it out for a share of $11,000 in our second semi-final. Alrighty, it's prize money time once again, and our runner-up team for tonight is that of Queensland. $500 coming up for them now. Here we go. Well done, Jack. That was a good one, Victoria. You had a bit of a battle with them all night, but just a bit too good.
Oh, they're an extremely good team, Victoria. We're the adversaries, though.
All right, well, you're back for the semi-final and a bit of training coming up, eh?
Yes, we're going to modify our technique.
Oh, good. Okay, well, we'll see you next time.
Thank you very much.
Righto, and our winning team for tonight, they've done a great job, and that is Victoria, and here's Peter Bolton, their captain. Good on you, Pete.
Thank you very much.
$1,000?
Oh, won't that be needed? Yes, be tremendous.
Now, you've got to worry about the semi-final.
We'll take that in 2 weeks' time. Yes, looking forward to it.
Well, you've had a perfect record, as we said before. Do you think you'll be able to maintain it?
Fingers crossed, legs crossed.
Okay, and just to make you a bit happier, you can start your own toy shop now because there's more games for all the
teams. Thank you very much.
All righty, there we go. Our winning team for tonight, and that's Victoria. Well, let's have a look and see how the points did finish up in all of the states, as all teams have now been through four times. And our top scoring team from New South Wales is St George up there with 37 points. Good work. 33 for Manly and 26 for Sutherland. In the Victorian section, some high scoring coming up here, but Melbourne City winning through with 79, Eltham with 61 and Preston 31. In the Queensland section, they were fairly close up there, but the winning team is Norman Park on 56, Logan Home 48, but in between there is Mount Gravatt on 49. And finally, South Australia, it was 60 points for Stirling. We had 46 there for Mitchum and Woodville, 6 points.
Thanks for coming, though, Woodville. We know you are great.
Right, semi-finalists for next week are...
We'll see three of our teams. tonight back again to battle with us in George, Melbourne City and Norman Park, and that very strong team from South Australia, Stirling.
And we're out of shapes as being a great night next week. All right, Warren, nice to have you with us again.
Oh, nice being here again, Billy.
And you had a fair bit of work to do there tonight too, I know.
Oh, yeah. I've got a bit of egg on my face for that county.
All right, we'll catch you again. And good night to Elizabeth and Lana. See you later.
Yes,
hope you'll join us next week. You betcha, because that's when all the big things are at as we get going with our semi-final. We'll see you then. Good night. Bye-bye.
Catch all the fun of the second semi-final on It's a Knockout next Saturday night at 7:30. Stay with Channel 10 now for your Bill Connan Saturday movie, The Trouble with Harry, starring Shirley MacLaine. Then at 10:35, Betty Hutton stars in The Miracle of Morgan's Creek.
Association with Network 10 Australia, Max Rowley speaking.